Hello and welcome to phase 3 on the rehabilitation after a rotator cuff repair. This phase starts around week 10 but could also start around week 13 if recovery is delayed. Phase 3 can be considered the early strengthening phase, and this phase consists of 11 exercises where the MVIC activity will start from 21 to 50%. It is therefore recommended to perform the exercises chronologically, starting with exercise 1, 2, etc.
The first exercise is the standing press-up, as described by Wu et al. In the year 2010. This exercise generated an MVIC of 29% for the supraspinatus and 14% for the infraspinatus. Before we start with the standing press-up, it is important that the washcloth press-up and supine press-up exercises of the previous phases can be performed properly before moving to the standing press-up. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position with your elbow bent, raise the arm of the affected side towards the ceiling, and then fully extend the arm with the scapula being protracted. Then move the arm to the starting position and repeat this exercise with respect to the pain. A variation to this exercise is to perform it while holding a small bottle or a weight. Perform this exercise with respect to the pain and repeat the exercise for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. The next exercise is the active flexion with the elbow bent as described by McCann et al. In the year 1993 and as recommended in a systematic review by Edwards et al. In the year 2017. This exercise generated an MVIC of 20% for the supraspinatus and 35% for the infraspinatus. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position and place the tip of your fingers on top of the affected shoulder. Start this exercise with your elbow low and then bring it up with respect to the pain while keeping the fingertips in contact with your shoulder. Because this exercise is performed with the elbow bent, the lever is short and the supraspinatus activity is relatively low. The next exercise is the active flexion with the elbow straight as described by Gant and McCann. This exercise generated an MVIC of 29% for the supraspinatus and 26% for the infraspinatus. This exercise is a variation of the previous exercise with the elbow bent. Stand in an upright position, raise the thumb off the affected side, and bring the arm at a 30 degree angle to the side so that the arm is not fully raised in the frontal plane. Then raise your arm up to a maximum of 160 degrees while keeping your elbow straight and your thumbs up. The next exercise is standing resisted shoulder extension as described by Myers et al. In the year 2005. This exercise generated an MVIC of 30% for the supraspinatus and 50% for the infraspinatus. For this exercise, use a pulley or an elastic band at a high, stable base. This means above shoulder height. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position. With your elbow straight, thumb pointing up, and you bring your shoulder forward to a 90 degree angle. From this starting position, you then extend your arm back as far as it will go and return to a 90 degree starting position while keeping your elbow extended. Perform this exercise with respect to the pain and repeat this for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. The next exercise is the standing external rotation as described by Myers, Reinhold and McCann. This exercise generated an MVIC of 35% for the supraspinatus and 50% for the infraspinatus. A variation of this exercise is that with a towel as a fixation. This variation increases the MVIC of the supraspinatus from 35% to 41% and for the infraspinatus from 50 to 39%. In this video, the exercise is demonstrated with a towel. Stand up straight with the elbow in a 90 degree bent position at the side, with or without a rolled up towel. Forearm in neutral position and thumb pointing up. To get to the starting position, the arm is brought into full internal rotation, then move the arm fully out to complete the external rotation and return to the starting position, maintaining the correct elbow and forearm position while keeping the thumb pointing up. The next exercise is the external rotation in side lying as described by Sakita et al. In the year 2015. This exercise generated the MVIC of 51% for the supraspinatus and 42 to 45% for the infraspinatus. Because the MVIC in this exercise is higher than 50%, it is recommended to do this later on in phase 3. To perform this exercise, lie on your side with your elbow bent at a 90 degree angle, forearm in neutral position and thumb pointing towards your head. From this 0 degree abduction, move the arm up towards the ceiling up to a maximum of 75 degrees and guided by the pain as described in a study by Sakita in 2015. According to science, this exercise is preferably performed with a towel below the elbow of the affected side. Repeat this exercise for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. The next exercise is the middle grip seated row, as described by Hintermeister in the year 1998 and as recommended by Edwards et al. In the year 2017. This exercise generated the MVIC of 33% for the supraspinatus. To perform this exercise, you use a pulley or attached elastic band at a height of 30 cm. The seated row is performed sitting on a chair with the face towards the attachment of the TheraBand or the pulley while holding the pulley or the elastic band. In the starting position, the arms are slightly bent, the hands are held at hip height, and the pulley or elastic band is stretched. The next exercise is the wide grip seated row, as described by Hintermeister in the year 1998 and as recommended by Edwards et al. In the year 2017. This exercise generated an MVIC of 39% for the supraspinatus and 31% for the infraspinatus. This exercise is a variation of the middle grip method, and to perform the wide grip method, the handles are held horizontally and the arms are raised at shoulder height, while the pulley or elastic band is pulled to a final position that extends beyond the width of the chest. The following exercises are the standing rows, as described by Ilias and Myers and as recommended by Edwards et al. In the year 2017. These exercises generated the MVIC of 40-46% for the supraspinatus and 29-31% for the infraspinatus. The high row was 42%, the middle row 40% and the low row 46%. For the high row, the elastic band or pulley is fixated at the high point, for the middle row at the height of your elbows, and for the low row at the height of your fingertips. To perform these row exercises, stand in an upright position with your elbow extended and your shoulder blades protracted. Pull back to tension the pulley or elastic band, and then pull your shoulder blade all the way back as you move your elbow from the extended position to a bent position. Then move your arm forward until the elbow is straight again to return to the starting position. The next exercise is the resisted active flexion, as described by Myers et al. In the year 2005. This exercise generated the MVIC of 42% for the supraspinatus and 47% for the infraspinatus. For this exercise, attach a pulley or elastic band to a low, stable base. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position, facing away from the attachment of the pulley or elastic band. With the elbow extended and the thumb pointing upwards, the arm is brought back to the starting position. Then move your arm forward as far as you can, guided by the pain, and return to the starting position. Repeat this exercise for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. The last and final exercise is the forward punch, as described by Ilias, Myers, Decker, and as recommended by Edwards et al. In the year 2017. This exercise generated an MVIC of 46% for the supraspinatus and 42% for the infraspinatus. For this exercise, you need to attach the stable base of the elastic band or pulley at the height of a door handle. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position, facing away from the stable base of the pulley or elastic band. The starting position of this exercise is the elbow fully flexed, forearm in neutral position, and scapula fully retracted. The exercise consists of flexing the shoulder to approximately 100 degrees, extending the elbow and fully protracting the scapula while punching forward and then returning to the starting position. Repeat this exercise for 3 sets of 10 repetitions with respect to the pain in the shoulder.